Ben Stark here, recording a draft video for ChannelFireball.com. We're doing a Shadows over Innistrad draft, so let's dive right in. Declaration in Stone is a good rare, but not something I consider amazing. It's nice that it kills any creature, but a lot of the creatures in this format investigate when they come into play, or just aren't particularly important. And when you're giving the opponent the card back, you're pretty much putting yourself down a card right away. So while that can be worth it in some instances, in other instances it's not. And I'll always play Declaration, and I think it's even a reasonably early pick, but I don't think it's a first pick rare. I don't think it's great. Nearheat Chaplain, on the other hand, is an uncommon that I love. I think it's the third best uncommon in the set behind Duskwatch, Recruiter, and Ongoing Investigation, and we're definitely going to take it here. Some other good cards in the pack: Halpak Wolf, Moorland Drifter, Thraben Inspector. I think I would probably take Declaration in Stone over Thraben Inspector, but I think that would be a close pick. But I think when you have what I consider, I don't want to say broken, but a really good uncommon in Nearheat Chaplain, then I think that's just a really clear pick. Drogskull Cavalry is decent. It's another rare that's, you know, it looks really powerful, but at 7 mana, 4/4 flying, it doesn't really impact the board that much the turn you play it. It's certainly not broken, but it can single-handedly win the game. You can play more defensively if you have it. And, you know, I mean, when you're gaining the 2 life as you're making the spirits, it's pretty hard for them to kill you. That's a big deal. I really like when they tack on the life gain. Well, I don't really like it when they make cards overly powerful, but in terms of a card being really good, I really like when they tack on the life gain to something like making creatures or drawing cards, because it means the opponent's going to have a really hard time trying to kill you while you're taking over the game. Ongoing Investigation is broken for that reason. I think if ongoing investigation didn't gain the 2 life whenever you removed a creature from the graveyard and investigated, it would still be good, but I think it would be nowhere near broken. Okay, here, other than that, I like the Necropod, but I wouldn't consider it over the Cavalry. Wildfield Scarecrow is good if you're Delirium, but it's really early. I think I'm going to take the Cavalry. I could see taking the Scarecrow. That's basically the only other card out of this pack I would even consider, but I do want to cut white, and Chaplain gains life and grinds pretty well since you get the 2/1s when you exile it. So I think we'll try and put together some kind of white deck that's prepared to go to the late game. At least as of right now. Of course, it's only 2 picks into the draft, and we don't know what we're going to see. So now there's Inspiring Captain, which is good in a white weenie deck. Not as good in a white late game deck, but, you know, we could just end up with more of a white aggro deck with just, you know, the Cavalry as a backup plan. It kind of weakens the Cavalry a little further, but it's not like white aggro is all in aggro in this format or something like that. Otherwise, this pack is pretty weak. Stormrider Spirit would be okay if we're going to try and draft spirits, which maybe we are. It's a solid playable. It might even be better than Inspiring Captain. Gloom Widow's okay. This pack is really bad. I guess we'll take Stormrider Spirit. See if we can draft like a blue-white spirits deck or something. That's not a deck I draft a lot, or something I've even really looked for in general. But given what we've started with, and Inspiring Captain being another 4-drop that's really good with a lot of small creatures, but not particularly good with a 7-drop and other 4-drops, I didn't really want to take it third there. It would have certainly been a reasonable pick, though. Okay, now we'll take Thraben Gargoyle. It's good because it blocks early and then flies late. It's kind of what a control deck would want. You don't want to fall behind against aggro, so if they play a 2-drop, you can just trade the Gargoyle. And then in the late game, it's a good threat. Also, we're not really taking it over anything. Unruly Mob is not really playable in this format. It's a lot worse than it was the first time we saw it. Intrepid Provisioner is good if you're green-white human aggro, but that's not the direction our white deck seems to be going. That's pretty much it. Humble the Brute's a sideboard card. I board it in sometimes, but I really don't like to start that card. I think it's quite powerful out of the board, but not something you want to main deck. Yeah, there's not a lot in these packs. Vessel of Ephemera is not something I usually play in my white weenie decks, but I probably will play if we have more of a spirit deck going, where we're trying to attack in the air, and we have some spirit synergies, hopefully. At least some Apothecary Geists to go with Drogskull Cavalry. Choked Estuary could offer us, you know, a black splash pretty easily. There's not a lot I think we're going to want to splash black for, as its removal is Deadweight, which I don't want to splash for, and Throttle, which, I mean, I really don't want to splash for. Just not good enough. So, I mean, there's not a lot in this pack. I think we'll take Vessel. I mean, it does make two spirits. It does look like we're trying to attack in the air with flyers and kind of block on the ground. It does fit our deck more than the normal white weenie deck, but I don't think Vessel's a great card. Along those lines, normally I take Strength of Arms over Expose Evil, because normally you're trying to attack on the ground and you need to clear out the high toughness guys, and you're more trying to trade up. But with this deck, I think we're going to be racing more. I think Expose Evil is going to offer us a lot more. I want to be able to fall a little behind as I put out my flyers and then tap their creatures and win the race. So I think Expose Evil offers a blue-white flyers deck more than Strength of Arms. Not really anything in this pack I want to play. Silent Observer, if the opponent is on an aggro deck, I think is pretty good. It blocks and has the potential, you know, to then attack for one. It's not a good attacker, and a lot of the decks in this format are trying to do big things, have big late game. So I really would not like to start it, but I could see myself boarding it in. Pretty much the rest of these cards are almost unplayable. Convicted Killer, obviously we're not red yet, and it's not even a great card. Hope Against Hope could be an okay sideboard card also, but better when you have cheaper creatures, not flyers. So let's grab the Silent Observer, though. I plan to not main deck it, unless we end up a little short or with a ton of cards that do things for spirits. True Faith Censor, similarly very good in the white weenie deck, not very good with flyers. But neither is Survive the Night, and there's nothing else really in this pack. And I do want to take something like True Faith Censor, because you don't know where the deck's going to go. We seem really well positioned to be fighting in the air, not on the ground. But there's still two packs left, and we might just get hit by a bunch of good ground white creatures, and our deck could take a different direction. So we'll take the True Faith Censor. Even though we're 100% locked in on white, we're not locked in on blue, and we're not definitely gonna end up the way our deck looks now, but I think it is pretty likely. I think our deck is pretty good. The synergy is there. So most likely, these cards just really are all bad. So most likely we're gonna end up in this direction. No reason to give someone a Clip Wings against our flyer deck, but Clip Wings is, I only hated it because there was absolutely nothing for us, and Clip Wings is not a great sideboard card because of all the 1/1 flying spirits. There are some formats where it would be a really powerful card, but in this format, I think it's pretty bad. I don't think these cards really matter. Let's see if we can open something good in pack two. Probably not going to play Gravestone or Unruly Mob. True Faith Censor, I'll leave there. Chaplain's a human. We don't have a lot of humans right now, but a lot of the white creatures are human, so kind of see what we get. Ooh, Bygone Bishop. Well, that's convenient. So that's just a broken rare. 3-mana 2/3 flyers, already good. 3-mana 2/2 flyers, pretty much the baseline, and vanilla flyers are better in this format than they are in general. Like, in the past couple formats, 5-mana 3/3 flyer, Stormrider Spirit, has been virtually unplayable. In this format, I don't want to say it's good, but it's playable. The first copy will usually make your deck. And Bygone Bishop being better than what I would consider general vanilla stats like 3-mana 2/2 flyer, because the third toughness is very important. But then you tack on this game-winning ability of anytime you play a creature with a converted mana cost of 3 or less, you get to investigate. That's huge. I mean, once you're sacking those clues and you're drawing more cards, it's not that hard to find more 3-mana creatures to investigate even more, and it can basically single-handedly take over the game. And that's all on a very efficient body. I would also love to get the Apothecary Geist out of this pack. Hopefully we can table it. It's not that deep a pack. Vessel of Nascency is pretty good. Hinterland Lager is solid. Jace's Scrutiny is a nice trick that I would also like to pick up, but I don't expect to table that. But I think we have a reasonable chance at tabling the Apothecary Geist. Okay, so Drownyard Explorer is okay for holding the ground. Jace of Scrutiny is a nice trick. Emissary is a spirit, but is a little expensive. I would probably play one, but I would have to pick it up later than this. I definitely wouldn't consider it over Drownyard Explorers or Jace of Scrutiny. But I think this is a close pick between the Scrutiny and the Explorers. Looking at what we have so far, 1-4 drop I want to play, one I'm kind of iffy on, a 5 drop and a 7 drop that I'm going to play, 3 drop. As far as tricks, we only have one Expose Evil. I think we could use the Jace's Scrutiny. We are planning on racing, so even gain 4 draw a card is not that bad for our deck, and I think we'll probably get some opportunities to block and then use the Scrutiny, since they're going to have to attack into us because they most likely won't be able to block our flyers. I expect the way the game to play is if we are ever able to cast a creature with 2 open, they'll probably be attacking into us and we'll be able to block Scrutiny. So this pack is really good and really bad for us. Fiery Temper and Kindly Stranger are great. Inner Struggle and Murderous Compulsion are solid removal. And we don't have any playables, really. There's no one card that really stands out. Like, Kindly Stranger is the best card by a decent amount, but not to the point where I'm going to hate it. And I am going to take Just the Win because maybe the opponent will have creature enchantments, or maybe we just won't end up with many spells, or we'll end up with playing, like, the 1-1 that discards a card to tap, or Catalog, or what have you. I don't think Just the Wind is particularly good, but I do think it's better in our deck, which may be, you know, racing a little more often than some of the other decks in the format that are just more interested in, you know, exchanging value. Okay, another medium pack. Strength of Arms and Stormrider Spirit are the only considerations for us. Luckily, this time we're not passing a bunch of first picks to everybody else. The rest of this pack is pretty weak. As far as our deck, this is a pretty close pick. I don't know if I want second Stormrider Spirit yet. I think I would definitely play 2, but I don't think the second is a big priority. I think we should probably take Strength of Arms, even though I don't think Strength of Arms is great in our deck, so maybe not. I guess we're going on the plan of attacking in the air, blocking a little bit on the ground, maybe some things like Expose and Scrutiny that race. Yeah, Strength of Arms just isn't really going to be great in our deck, I don't think. I think we should go with the Stormrider Spirit and stick with the flyer plan. Okay, Erdwall Illuminator is a really good card. We don't investigate that much, but with the Bishop, we could really go off, although that's probably unnecessary. But we do have Expose Evil and Jace's Scrutiny already, and we will prioritize the Drown Yard Explorers next time we face a close pick. Let's say between that and something else that investigates. It's also a 2-mana 1/3 Flying Spirit, so it's pretty much a no-brainer. It's exactly what we're looking for. Along those lines, Uninvited Geist is also a 3-mana 2/2 Spirit. Skulk, and we can use our Scrutinies or our Expose Evils or Adjust the Winds, what have you, to get in with it. And once it flips, it's a pretty good card for us. Usually blue isn't that aggro, so I found Uninvited Geist to be pretty bad in a lot of blue decks, but we're kind of a blue-white tempo deck, so kind of exactly what we're looking for. And when I say tempo, what I mean is we're trying to attack back and forth and use bounce and tap to kind of end the game while the opponent still has cards in hand or better stuff than us out. You know, I think that's a term that's often misused. I don't mean just aggression when I say it. An aggressive deck that's looking to attack on the ground is an aggressive deck. Tempo to me means you would want things like bounce, where you're down a card but you're trading up mana, or flyers and tap effects where you're trying to, they're going to have a better board than you, but you're presenting lethal, you know, kind of quicker than them. But I know that's a hot button issue in the Magic community, so I'll move on. Jace's Scrutiny is a good trick for us. It's even better now that we have Erdwall Illuminator, and it's kind of what we were trying to do anyway, so I'll happily pick up a second and play a second one of those. Nothing here. Although Grotesque Mutation is okay, we'll hate these cards just because there's nothing for us. And with virtually all of our creatures flying, I don't think we're going to play True Faith Censor. Plus, we've picked up a bunch of other tricks. I see no real reason. Play a Censor when we have Press for Answers, Just the Wind, Double Scrutiny, Expose Evil, most of which investigate and do a better job of tapping the creature, stalling the game a little bit while we win in the air. And our deck is pretty good at winning in the air. I mean, it could use a little help, but we do have double Stormrider Spirit, Drogskull Cavalry, Uninvited Geist now if that hits, Nibilis, Bygone Bishop. It's looking really good. So Slayer's Plate is something I would play, but Erdwall Illuminator is just a clear pick. Like I said before, it's very efficient, and since we took the previous one, we've picked up a second Scrutiny and a Press for Answers. Even a Gone Missing that I might now play. It's not a card I like a lot, but with double Illuminator and a Flyers deck, I think it might be good enough. Our deck is really good at investigating. It wants the Spirits, it wants the Flyer, it's an efficient body. It's kind of a no-brainer. Stitch Mangler is the best blue common by a lot, in my opinion. Sleep Paralysis, Just the Wind are fine. Stitch Mangler is really good. Taking down that one key blocker or putting a 2-3 on the ground. Expose Evil is something we want, and I would play a second, but we do have a lot of spells, and I think if we table it, that's great, or pick one up later, that's great, but if not, I think Stitch Mangler is just too much better. So I think we have to let that go. Griff's Boon is actually not nearly as broken in our deck as it is in a normal White Weenie deck, since most of our creatures fly. But it's still recursive, so I think we'll still probably play it. Also, we're not really taking it over anything. As you can see, this pack has a Militant Inquisitor, and we have no equipment, or a Stormrider Spirit. Basically, are the only other playables in our color. But it is disappointing that that's the uncommon that we see here, because Griff's Boon is really broken in a a fast, aggressive, ground-pounding White Weenie deck, and pretty mediocre in our deck. And now there's basically nothing, so this pack just stinks for us. It's not great for other people either. There's not a whole lot of good cards in this pack. Just take the Fortified Village in case we get an ongoing investigation somehow. I wouldn't expect that to happen, but if it did, I would definitely love to have the green source. This is an easy Moorland Drifter. It's tough to get good twos. It's a spirit. We're not great at Delirium, but we can get there. And, we have instants and sorceries, enchantments and creatures, an artifact. And 2-mana 2-2 anyway. So, pretty easy pick. Not an exciting one. I'm kind of disappointed that we weren't able to pick up any Apothecary Geist. I think that card is really good in our deck. So far, I mean, it's not something people are taking early, so we probably have a couple packs left at it. But, it's really good when you're adding another flyer and gaining three, and it's a good blocker, and I doubt anybody else at the table has a spirit focus like we do. So I definitely thought we would have a pretty good shot to pick up Apothecary Geists. And I know we saw one that we took something really good over, I think, and that's the only one I can recall seeing. Nagging Thoughts is okay. I'm not going to take second Gone Missing. I think first Gone Missing will make our deck with double Illuminator. But, I mean, I'm not going to play second Gone Missing. And Nagging Thoughts is cheap. It can help get us Delirium if that ends up being something we want. Plus, it just kind of has that effect of being part spell, part land, in that if you don't have any more lands, you can, keep the land, bin the spell a lot of the time. If you have more lands than you need, you can, bin the land, keep the spell. It's not nearly as good as Vessel of Nascency at doing that, but it's still useful in smoothing out your draws. Strength of Arms, now over virtually nothing. Ethereal Guidance, not a card I really plan on maining, but if our opponent, can't kill any of our creatures and it's just a straight race, we do have some pretty cheap flyers that don't hit that hard now that we have double Illuminator, and we have the ability to stall for a little bit with Scrutinies. So I could definitely see one Ethereal Guidance making our deck. Now we pick up that Expose Evil, and a third. Okay, well, I don't think Ethereal Guidance is going to make our deck anymore, because I'll probably just play all the Expose Evils, given we have double Illuminator and a bunch of Flyers. These picks don't really matter. We can even start cutting some of these. They're not going to make the deck. Considering we ended up with virtually all Flyers, I don't think Griff's Boon's even going to make our deck. It's weird, because it's such a good card, but what makes that card really good is giving a creature flying, not giving it +1/+0. And we're going to have a lot of clues to sack our mana on. So I think that Griff's Boon is offering us the least I could really imagine Griff's Boon offering a deck. Strength of Arms, probably not going to make it either since we picked up all these Expose Evils. This puts us 13 creatures, 24 land at the moment. That might be correct, but probably we want 17 land. Especially if we play Drog School Calvary. Thinking about this nagging thoughts, if we play 16 land and a nagging thoughts plus all these 2-mana cards, that's probably fine. It's kind of tough to get to 7 with 16, but not when you're drawing so many cards. I don't really want to miss land drops that much, but I also don't want to be too thin. And we should have a lot of clues, and we should have some time to cast them. And 8 and 8 seems fine. We have cheap white cards, cheap blue cards. Yeah, I think we'll do 16. Magic Online often recommends more of a disparity in your lands than I agree with. I'm sure mana symbol-wise, 9 Islands, 7 Plains makes sense, but when you're a 2-color deck with cheap cards in both colors, you just really don't have the luxury of playing the exact lineup of mana symbols to land ratio, because you're not going to win games if you don't find both kinds of mana right away. So that's why, you know, Magic Online will often suggest 10-7 and I'll make it 9-8, or, you know, 9-7 and I'll make it 8-8. It's pretty rare that I'll actually play like 10-7 unless I have double color cheap cards. Like, there's not much in this format, but I think like there's the rare wolf that's a 2-2, a red to cast. If I have stuff like that, then I may play 10 mountains, because it's not always that easy to cast a double color casting cost card on turn 2 when you only have 9. But you should draw 1 of 9 and 1 of 8 pretty often. But once you start going down to 7 and 6, you know, it becomes substantially less likely that you won't hit one of your main colors, which is pretty much a deal breaker for me. All right, I will see you back for round 1.